During the early afternoon of October 2nd, a volcano within India's Andaman and Nicobar Islands erupted near a populated area. Yet, I am not referring to a true volcano, although the nation's barren island volcano was indeed erupting actual lava at the same time, a mere 118 kilometers to the east. Instead, I am referring to a mud volcano which produced its first eruption in 20 years. And this was not a minor eruption either, like you might typically see on the edges of part of California's Salton Sea. As instead, a loud noise was heard when large volumes of mud quickly erupted to heights of what may have been 100 feet, soon falling back to the ground and covering a wide area. Within only a few minutes' time, 3,000 square meters, or a little more than half the size of an American football field, was covered by an average of 10 feet or 3 meters thick of mud. Now, while I do want to stress that some local estimates suggest a lower figure, it regardless was an unusual event which could have harmed tourists if they had been there at the time. Thankfully, no tourists were present, so all that was damaged was a viewing area for this particular mud volcano. But why did this mud volcano erupt in the first place? After all, its last eruption in 2005 was thought to have been triggered by the infamous magnitude 9.2 earthquake in December 2004. So far on my channel, I have discussed mud volcanoes which originated from one of two things: rising gases from a magma chamber at a volcano, or rising gases associated with an oil and/or natural gas deposit. And yet, while those two types of mud volcanoes do represent a large portion of existing world mud volcanoes, they are not the only thing which can naturally create them. It just so happens that the mud volcano which erupted fell into the quote-unquote other category, which completely owes its existence to the area's geologic setting. You see, the Andaman Islands are not volcanic in origin. Instead, they relate to the tectonic plate collisions occurring to the east and west of the island chain. As the Indian plate to the west subducts eastwards, the plate carries with it large volumes of sediment that have formed on top of it. Yet, these sediments do not largely subduct into the mantle, instead piling up over time above where the two colliding plates are touching to form a large mass known as an accretionary wedge. The Andaman Islands represent the surface exposure of that accretionary wedge, which has become so thick it rose above sea level in some spots. And in these accreted sediments that comprise the accretionary wedge, there are abundant remains of dead sea creatures, both large and microscopic, including plankton. This organic material over time decomposes, largely through the interaction of microbes which through processing them release gases such as methane. The rising gas then interacts with the abundant sediments, forming a muddy mass that is propelled upwards by said gas. This eventually reaches the surface, erupting to form a mud volcano. And that is why the Andaman Islands contain nearly a dozen mud volcanoes. Despite the aforementioned eruption being large in the context of mud volcanoes, it was small in the context of larger eruptions at mud volcanoes, if that makes any sense, since the largest eruptions of mud volcanoes can reach volumes upwards of 100,000 cubic meters. For comparison, the Andaman mud volcano on October 2, 2025, at most, only ejected 9,000 cubic meters of fresh mud. If you are wondering, these are the coordinates of the mud volcano I have been discussing, and yes, that is the second mud volcano 1,300 meters to the immediate west-northwest. I hope that you found this video interesting. If you would like to request a specific topic for me to cover, please leave a comment below. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member, Coco Faye, for supporting my work.